So dollar index, as per the diagram that I previously explained to you, is trading according to the Elliott wave, and according to my Elliott wave labeling, is trading within a corrective pattern. So let's see, from the actual bottom, which is the 5 in the ending diagonal right there in 2008, surprisingly, basically the US dollar gained strength against everything else while everything else was dropping. So we will basically keep that in mind. Now, the way I'm labeling this is as an ABC intermediate turquoise, basically ending this A on the primary scale. Now, right after that, we started contracting. We started with a corrective pattern in a zigzag, basically ABC red intermediate, finalizing this B wave on the primary scale, so basically this blue B wave. Now on the upside, this can be obviously counted as a WXABC or WX and then excuse me okay and then W X A B C for the Y. So anyway, the point is that we went on the upside, and I'm simply labeling this as a running flat intermediate green 2 after the rise in the leading diagonal in 1, and then followed by a surge, basically a rally, obviously on the upside for this intermediate 3. Now right after that, we had a complex WXY in intermediate 4, which took form as a basically as an expanded flat right here, and then we went on the upside with an ending diagonal right there. Now following up, of course there's a lot to talk about this the dollar index. However, I want you to basically take a look at the FIBs 161.8 from primary A to primary B, worked out perfectly. So right after that, of course, this entire move, this entire ABC would have this FIBs in focus, because this ABC would typically correct the cycle wave A, this black A right here. And as you can see, I have basically marked this left shoulder head and the upcoming right shoulder right around the corner. So therefore, I'm gonna zoom in here, and basically I'm gonna expand this this chart so you can actually see. Now the way I'm labeling this is obviously as a B wave, as basically a possible contraction on the longer term. Now obviously this is the weekly chart, so it might as well take some time. And notice that we do have possible upcoming divergence right here, and the way I'm labeling this A is within ABC on the intermediate scale. So we have AB and then 1 2 3 4 5. We already have the low, but for that I'm gonna zoom in so that you can actually see. Now obviously this rise was during President Trump's the presidency and everything. So let's zoom in. Now the point is that right here we obviously had the divergence visible, so I have to be honest with you, I was actually ready for that possibility, and I did obviously post this possible move. And then of course we went on the downside in an ABC with an ending diagonal in minor C red, thus completing intermediate A. Now right after that, things got a little bit wary with the Federal Reserve and everything, with the stimulus and tightening, etc., with the rates. So basically we went on the upside within this intermediate B, with this turquoise B in a WXY double free type of structure. Now right after that, of course everybody was wary, everybody was afraid of what's happening, but obviously I saw it coming. So this is obviously a head and shoulders pattern. Then it started going down basically for this intermediate C. Now, as you can see, this intermediate C is quite abrupt and quite extended. Yeah. So anyway, those that are close to me, and which those who are following me, they know that I was present here on the top, here, basically, let's say here, 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 and most important here, and also here, and also here, and I am present right here. Okay, so anyway, for those who are new to my analysis, there are ways to follow me. Obviously, I'm presenting live webinars on a scheduled basis. I'm posting this type of possible scenarios and analysis, Elliott wave analysis. There are ways to reach out and also ways to follow me. Just look into it if you wish. Now let's continue. What this analysis states is that we are possibly ending very, very soon. We are possibly ending a minor degree in the red 5, and obviously this would end intermediate C, but that's ending intermediate A. Yeah. So going back on the long term chart, on the weekly chart. Yeah, we would have this type of scenario, and of course at the 50% levels typical for a wave A in an extended C, we could see a reaction here. Now, not to say that it's going directly here, as you may have noticed, I am expecting that type of retracement, and then of course the final leg. Now if that would occur, then obviously the divergence would be even better and possibly confirm. Now, leaving us, of course, with a retracement on the upside, yeah, a retracement of the on the upside, according to these fibs for this B. Now, how I'm actually seeing this on the larger scale is as a possible head and shoulders formation for the cycle to end. Possibly end in this primary C. Yeah, so that leaves us with possibly ending A and going a corrective pattern towards B, towards basically having a right shoulder, and then we'll see if this happens. Yeah, normally of course this is a vibration level right here, so it's closely to be closely watched. But then again, this is a weekly chart, hence the reason why I think that the market could be ready for a shift. The market could be shifting. Yeah. So during this corrective pattern, which I'm expecting it to be quite complicated, something like this, like in this 4 right here, intermediate 4, yeah, the market could have some sort of the market could cause a shift. Market could be shifting and causing, thus causing, of course, the indices to contract on the primary scale as well. So yeah, exactly what I shown you previously on the Dow Jones and the S&P 500. So going back on the daily chart, yeah, let's basically continue. So after this 1-2, notice that I have some fib levels on the downside there. Yeah, so from A to B, I'm basically targeting basically the 300% for this intermediate C from A to B according to this analysis. Now, after that, from one and two, this is basically the minor free target, the 300% as well. And notice that we already hit the 38.2 from the entire A right there, yeah? So that leaves us with the extension being basically in this minor free. But minor free has 1-2 on the minute scale, then 3, then 4 in an expanded flat, and then the extension in its subwaves, minuets, black 1-2, 3-4, and then 5, basically ending minute 5, which was extended, and the extension itself in the minor free red. So Basically, you can actually see how I label the fibs basically on the Fibonacci scale. And then here we had this divergence, which I saw it coming, and obviously I started posting again this possible opportunity, and there you go. It went on the upside right there. Yeah, in a corrective pattern for this four, this minor minor on the minor scale. So we hit the 38.2 default measurement for the four, and these reversal areas were basically present since I was actually preparing to post. So somewhere around August, end of August, I was actually placing this reversal areas, trend continuations, etc., and pretty far. I mean, so far they worked out perfectly. Yeah, you can actually see how they gained support or even got resistances. So anyhow, the point is that we went on a downside there right after I started posting that. Of course, there is a possibility for the dollar to continue for the minor five. So all I did was basically, you can actually see that this is basically what I'm trying to explain to you with Elliott wave analysis. If done correctly, of course, there is a possibility for you to be for you to always be one step ahead. Yeah, if the analysis is done correctly, of course. I mean, it's very complicated, but it can be it can act like the ace in the sleeve. So yeah, so we went basically on the downside right here, and then reverse. Now obviously on the 12th of December, it was a busy day for the Federal Reserve. Yeah, this is where exactly when I started posting, and I basically posted a possible bearish outcome, because I was actually expecting the free, let's say, technically speaking and according to my analysis. So this is exactly what happened there. So for that, I'm going to explain to you how I actually analyzed that. Now obviously we had a drop in wave one, so 61.8 of it, default measurement for a wave two to retrace, was in my view. But for that, I'm going to zoom in, yeah, so that you can actually see. So we went basically on the downside, and the way I actually looked at things is basically an ABC pattern for a W, then X. This couldn't have been the entire corrective, so therefore I marked it as a next, yeah, and then an ABC on the upside with a running flat in B with a WXY complex structure. So from A to B, we hit the 161.8 and we confirmed basically the C, yeah, and then again from A to B we confirm 161.8 again for the Y. Now right after that we started dropping. I'm gonna take you guys step by step. So this is exactly what happened. Now we went on the downside for the first leg, and then we started contracting here. A bit uncommon for a wave two, but it can happen. I mean, yeah, so we have basically wave W, X, and then ABC in Y, not going basically beyond the start of wave one, so it's okay, it met all the rules. And then we went on the extension, yeah, 1, 2, 3 triangle in four, and then five completing three. And notice that I had this channel, yeah, which is coming from way down here. And then of course, just when I noticed this minuet wave four, I placed this channel, the base of the channel, for the possible breach and confirmation for the breach, and then of course waiting for the retracement so that it can be the scenario, the better scenario, will work out nicely. So the way I looked at things during the event, so I was actually ready for we've confirmed, let's say, the possible start in minor five, I mean the downtrend, yeah. And I said, okay, well, if we're gonna go up, in November, at the end of November, if we're going to go up, we need a corrective pattern. Yeah, so I need a corrective pattern to confirm my analysis. So there we go. We went on a leading diagonal in A, then retracement here in an ABC in a zigzag, and then ending diagonal right here for the C wave, basically this orange orange C. Now the way we went on the upside, this is what this is the interesting part. Yeah, so 61.8 of minute one. This is the default measurement for retracement of wave two. So that tick the box. Yeah. Then again, from A to B, Fibonacci extension 161.8 for the end of C, tick the box. So you see, this is how I actually align things. Not to mention that I've noticed all obviously these possible head and shoulders formation, so I treated the second wave as the possible right shoulder. And what do you know? Everything worked out nicely and dollar index started a downtrend. Yeah, now what I'm gonna do here is basically go through step by step. So we're approaching real time, really basically what's happening right here. Yeah, we started going on the downside, went on the upside in a typical corrective pattern, then we go on the downside again in an extension in wave three. Yeah, so you can see from one to from one towards two, we've basically reached 261.8. Yeah, but also 100% of wave one, and obviously 150% right here would be this target. Yeah, so how would we go? How would we go there? Let's take it step by step, so I don't really confuse you guys. I know it's complicated, but I know there's a lot of things here on this chart. But within all this mess, for me it makes perfect sense. Yeah. So let's see. We went on the downside 1-2 on the subminuet scale, and then again 1-2 micro, sub micro, and so on. Yeah, we went on the downside, and then we corrected. Again, you see this channel that I drew, just like a border for me to get things going here, for me to see which you know how to react on things. Now ABC, we hit the 38.2 of minuet free. Yeah, so far so good. Now again we started reversing sub minuet one and then two extension, sharp extension, very deep extension, I mean big extension in wave three, causing a 300%. Then we started to bounce off. Now is this the end, the five? Yeah, this is basically, you know, because the market can play tricks on you. So keep in mind that for a wave three from one towards two, for a wave three to be extended, and it's, clearly it's extended, right? I mean, it has to be. 100% was reached a long time ago. So the market can play tricks on you. Is this move the five? You know, is it the five or not? At this stage, I'm beginning to think not, right? Because we have three moves on the downside. We don't have five. So which leads me to think that we have a fake breakout. This is an A. This is basically the B. Yeah? Or a W. So let's see. Is it an A or a W? How are we going on the upside? Are we going a five swing sequence? Sure, if this will be an ending diagonal, of course. Yeah? But I don't see it as an ending diagonal just yet. So therefore, I'm going to label it as a W, X, and then Y. This would be a micro scale. Yeah. So there we go. Now, obviously, the reason behind that is another. I mean, there's another reason behind that, because in this free, extensive free, which obviously presented an extension, we have low volumes right there. So in order for us to have a proper divergence, we need to have to see something like this on the volumes while the price action would be dropping, so we can actually go in three moves and complete this pattern right there. Yeah, and obviously right after that this channel would be treated as something to, let's say, slide onto. Yeah, so if this is correct. If this is not correct, obviously this is what it's all about. I mean, Elliott wave trading, I'm trying to explain to you here some ground rules. Elliott wave trading is not something that you can treat as something clear. I mean, 100% clear. Okay, there it goes. We have a confirmation. It will clearly go that way. No, not at all. The market can develop multiple structures, and what you need to know is how those structures could develop and what are the chances for those structures to develop that way. I mean, if, for instance, this example right here, if this is giving you a free, yeah, why would you treat this as a as the entire corrective? Doesn't really make any sense. Yeah, the only way it can convince you right there is basically by spiking, yeah, and going towards the 38.2 right there and hit your golden ratio levels. Hitting your golden ratio levels right there, yeah. But to be honest with you, I still I'm still slightly, and I mean, I know it's a little bit dodgy, yeah. It could be we need to be I need to be careful here, yeah, because I'm still inclining for a slightly drop. I mean, this is only the 2-hour chart. You cannot really, I mean, of course I would at this stage I would turn my focus towards the bullish side, right? I'm not going to be stubborn, because market can go up anytime at this point. The point that I'm trying to make is that I would very much like to have these FIBs hit, right, in order for everything to pan out nicely and all my boxes to be ticked, and obviously gain more confidence for that possible up move right there. Yeah, so as I said, it can go from here, but it can also go from there. But if it goes to 161.8, my confidence will increase. This is what I'm trying to explain to you. Yeah, because once you have all the pieces to the puzzle lining up right there, you would be much more confident for you know, for the trend change. And guess what, you will actually catch catch the turn. This is the beautiful part about Elliott wave analysis. So that's that. I mean, let me just go over this thing just one more time as a summary. Yeah, so as basically short term, medium term wise, I would expect this 161.8 to be hit. I know it's a bit, I mean, we already hit one more low, so it can go anytime on the upside. But the point is that I would expect a sharp correction, one which would obviously hit this previous four from a lesser degree according to the rules. Yeah, also hitting some important fibs right there. Okay, and possibly just, you know, hover around on this. I would expect a complex correction, because after a sharp drop like that, we could even have a triangle or a complex combination, because the retracement in wave two was a simple corrective. Yeah, so I would expect a complex structure, hence the reason why I think that everything else would contract in complex type of structures. And I would expect some wild swings, especially on the Euro USD, which by the way is next for the analysis. So let me actually show you a couple of things on Euro dollar.